ladies and gentlemen, Patrick Stewart.
You are very kind, and I am delighted to be here hosting Saturday Night Live. Now, although in my career I played a variety of roles, stage, film, television, I am under no illusion as to why I'm here. Tonight, it's because of Star Trek: The Next Generation. Well, now, thank you very much, but I have a confession to make. When I was first given the role of Captain Jean-Luc Picard, I pretended to take it all in my stride. I was so cool. In interviews, I claimed never to have seen the original classic Trek. But it was all an act. Because inside, I was so ecstatic, I was delirious. You see, not only am I probably the biggest Star Trek fan of all time, but, well, as my friends can tell you, I am virtually an encyclopedia of Star Trek facts and trivia. Well, no, for example, listen. Here's a fact I'll bet you don't know. On the original show, the name of the spaceship was not the Star Trek. No. No. It was, in fact, the Enterprise. Now, that's true. Now, all right. Now, here's another one. Everyone knows that the part of Captain James M. Kirk was played by William Shiner. Now, and of course later he was to become very famous as the $6 Million Man. But how many of you here know which actor played the chief medical officer, Dr. McCrae? Who was of course otherwise known as Boney. You give up, don't you? Well, that was Forrest D. Kelly. Well, perhaps you knew that one, but can you name to me the ship's other medical officer? Because, of course, there were two. You see, you're stumped. You are forgetting Dr. Spock. Now you remember, right? He was the pointy-eared creature, you know? Half-human, half-volcano. And he was... He was forever tormenting old Boney with his cold volcano logic. And, all right, here's another bit of trivia. Did you know that another Star Trek character, Captain Sulu, was the first black woman ever on television? Anyway, being the Star Trek trivia maniac that I am, well, you can imagine my feelings when I first learned that I'd won the role of Captain Picard. I felt a kinship, you know, with all those unforgettable legendary characters, Kirk, Boney, and especially Spock. And I even, I wrote a note to Leonard Portnoy, but I guess he never received it. Anyway, Leonard, if you're watching, this is for you. Outer space. The last frontier. These are the trips of the Star Trek Enterprise. Its five-year plan calls for us to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new life and new civilizations, to boldly fly where no man has gone in space. Live long. And be happy. Well, we have got a great show tonight. Salt and Pepper is here. because we'll be back.